six-figure custom cars, $250,000 shoes. And from there, it just gets crazier. These are 10 items Zion Williamson owns that cost more than your life. And with Zion's first purchase, not only was it expensive, but it was controversial too. Coming into the 2019 NBA draft, Zion knew that he was going to be a top pick, so he needed to look fresh. That's why Zion went out and spent big on a custom-made suit. But when he walked onto that stage, his suit looked really familiar. This man stole LeBron's entire look. But that's not even the worst part. He spent over $10,000 to do it. Now, 10 grand before he ever got an NBA check? That's pretty stupid. But what if I told you that suit was the cheapest thing Zion was wearing that night? Yeah, when Zion dapped up his cousin, something immediately caught my eye. This man was wearing a diamond Rolex watch. And I just had to know, how much did Zion spend on it? Well, I decided to do a little bit of digging, and my mind was blown. Zion spent $120,000 on this watch. Ridiculous. But this was just the beginning of Zion's ridiculous spending. I mean, his garage at just 20 years old will have you questioning your entire life. See, when Zion got into the NBA in 2019, everyone knew that he was the next big thing. So companies were breaking down his door, begging him to rep their brands. And there was one sponsorship that Zion couldn't turn down. Mercedes-Benz. It turns out that Mercedes hit him up, and they gave him the deal of a lifetime. They offered the man a $150,000 all-black Mercedes AMG S63 sedan for free. Sheesh. But it turns out giving away a car for free was a great move for Mercedes, because Zion went out and spent his first NBA check on two more Benzes. First, he bought a brand new $150,000 2020 G-Wagon. Equipped with heated leather seats, 3-zone climate control, over 3 feet of... Okay, basically, this car is just really comfortable, alright? But it's the second Mercedes that was the big baller. Zion went out and got a $160,000 2020 AMG GT63 S. And, I mean, this thing. This is for when Zion wants to go fast. 630 horsepower, 9-speed transmission, 660 pounds of torque. This thing goes 0 to 60 in only 2.9 seconds, and it tops out at almost 200 miles per hour. Damn. Now look, this car is beautiful, Zion, but just be careful out there, alright? There's already been too many people injured this season, alright? Can't lose you too. But what's even crazier is that all three of Zion's Mercedes add up to over $460,000 in cars. Damn, Zion! Just to drive? Ridiculous. Now, what if I told you Zion has a secret addiction that's costing him tens of thousands of dollars? Yeah. There's one thing that Zion loves a little too much.
Me and a group of friends, we went to see Avengers Endgame. And if you know me, Thanos is my favorite character.
This man is a Thanos addict. I mean, he dropped over $1,000 on custom-made, one-of-a-kind, Thanos-inspired Jordan 34s. But that's just $1,000. Zion, he wipes his ass with that. The real money was spent when Zion hit up Zoe Frost, a famous celebrity jeweler. And Zion requested the most iced-out Thanos piece you'll ever see. This man, Zion, literally bought his own Infinity Gauntlet for $50,000. Jesus. But Zion's not always just dropping stacks on himself, alright? Sometimes, he likes to spend big on his people. He's all about paying respect to the people that helped him over the years. I mean, Zion knows without his family, he'd have never made it to the NBA in the first place. So, after he got drafted, his first thought wasn't to go out and buy himself something nice. It was to buy his cousin something nice. A brand new car. But Zion wasn't trying to gift his cousin a damn Corolla, alright? He wanted to go all out. So, he reached out to one of the best car shops in the entire country, Dreamwork Motorsports. And after speaking with the owner, he found the perfect gift. A brand new 2019 Jeep Wrangler. And this car should have only cost him around $50,000. But the man decided to drop another 10 grand, fully customizing this thing out. He amped up the engine, threw on some custom paint, new rims, wheels, even had Subscribe to Rebound painted on the side of the Jeep. Yeah, that's right. Everywhere Zion's cousin goes, the people know to subscribe to Rebound. And if you're not subscribed, he's finna run you over. So what are you doing? Damn, Zion. This man really knows how to pick out a present. But I think Zion needs to learn how to save some cash, cause one mistake lost him hundreds of thousands of dollars. See, when Zion played for Duke back in 2019, he laced up his Nike PG 2.5s for a game against UNC. And during the first possession of that game, this happened.
And 36 seconds into the game, Zion Williamson is down.
He blew through his shoe.
Yeah.
Look at his left shoe. He blew completely through the shoe, and then he started holding his right knee. I mean, his shoe blew apart. I've never seen anything like that.
Hold up. Was that Obama? This man got the president out here watching him. That's some next level shit. Damn. But Zion almost had his entire career ruined because of some damn Nikes. But what's crazy about this situation is how much these shoes ended up being worth. See, shortly after the accident, famous sports auctioneer Ken Golden went on TMZ, and he was asked about how much Zion's Nikes were worth.
What's the ceiling? Like, what would be the upper range that you could see this thing going for at auction?
I've seen NBA worn on one game All-Star jerseys go for $180,000. It would not surprise me if it topped $250,000.
$250,000? Damn! Alright, so with that much money on the line, you'd think that Zion would go and just sell those Nikes immediately, right? Well, this is where things get mysterious. See, a few days after the accident, Zion gave the shoes to Duke's athletic director to get them checked out by Nike. And some shady stuff must have gone down, because after Nike inspected them at Duke's facility, those shoes went missing. How the hell does a $250,000 pair of Nikes just vanish into thin air? All right, the people need answers. So once again, TMZ took matters into their own hands. They went out and asked Zion where the shoes were, and he said to ask his coach. So, TMZ asked his coach, and he said to ask Nike. So, TMZ went and asked Nike, and they said they have no idea where the shoes were. So these sneakers are officially lost. And they still are to this day. $250,000 just down the drain in a dumpster somewhere, gone. That's tragic. But even though Zion lost all of this money, he'll be fine. The man is making big bread in the NBA. I mean, nowadays, Zion spends more money customizing cars than most people do actually buying one. Like when he bought himself a brand new Ford F-150 Raptor. As if dropping $55,000 on this thing wasn't enough, Zion wanted to spice things up even more. So when his 1 year NBA anniversary came around, he decided to treat himself and hit up Dreamwork Motorsports again. And when I tell you that this man had everything done to his truck, I'm not joking. I'm talking window tint, customized red leather seats, painted brakes and suspension, a sound system, 22-inch custom painted wheels, 35-inch tires, smoked lights. They even installed light bars with his catchphrase, "Let's dance," on it. And it doesn't stop there, because after all of that, they spent over 12 hours wrapping the truck in satin black. I don't even know what that means. But it looks pretty dope. We don't care how beautiful this thing is. How much did it cost? Well, the customizations ended up totaling around $20,000. This man's customizations cost more than my entire car. Zion's out here making me look broke, man. Damn. I mean, Zion's got so much money. He just throws it away sometimes. And I know that sounds crazy, but let me explain. See, back in 2018, Zion wore a pair of Kyrie 5s during a game at Duke. And at that time, he didn't nearly have the same hype. So, after the shoes got old, Zion, he didn't think twice about it. He just threw them away. But only a year later, when Zion made it to the NBA, something weird happened. I guess some dude went dumpster diving or something, because those same pair of Kyrie 5s ended up on Golden Auction's website, and they were worth a lot more money now. I mean, who wouldn't want a pair of NBA history? So, they started the bidding off at $7,500. And after 9 people went back and forth bidding on them, a final deal had been reached. And they sold for over $19,000. Damn, that's like $2,000 per toe. Ridiculous. I guess one man's trash is another man's treasure. And I'm starting to think Zion is King Midas, because everything this dude touches turns to gold, literally. Back in 2020, Zion played his first NBA game ever. And I mean, this was a historic night. So the NBA wanted to take full advantage, and they decided to auction off his debut jersey. Now obviously, Zion's a superstar, and people were lining up, ready to drop bands on this thing. But I don't even think the NBA expected there to be this much interest. Because just a few days later, when they put the jersey online, over 100 people put bids in. And the jersey ended up selling for over $80,000. $80,000 for a shirt?
I think I'm having a heart attack. Oh,
clear. But, I mean, you know, we're talking about Zion Williamson here. Like, the shoes he wore during his first win, for example. The dumpster diving freaks at Golden Auctions somehow got those too. And they ended up selling for $62,000. It's just unbelievable. This dude is a walking dollar sign. And it's pretty cool to see, because, you know, Zion, he's one of the most humble guys in the NBA. But not everyone is as nice as Zion. Some guys are just assholes. Like Michael Jordan. He disrespected tons of players over the years. I mean, one time, he even gave his own teammate a black eye, just for looking at him wrong. Huh, you wanna hear more about that? Click on this video right here. These are the times that Michael Jordan disrespected NBA players. Trust me, man, you wanna see what Michael Jordan said. So what are you doing? This video's over. Click it.